This is a production of PBS 39.
Good evening. Thanks so much for joining us. I'm Amy Burkett. Pennsylvania is one of six states to recently receive $500,000 in grants to promote science and math to students. Experts report these fields will drive the U.S. economy in the next century. In tonight's Lehigh Valley at Work segment, Laura McHugh explores programs that already target future technology leaders.
For a flower, the stem provides a lifeline. The sturdy stalk supports the leaves and petals, a delivery system for the nutrients the blossom needs to survive. But for the U.S. economy to survive in the global market, state leaders now bank on a whole different kind of STEM.
STEM stands for Science, Technology, Engineering, and Mathematics.
Administrators at Lehigh University believe these four areas will prove critical to keeping our state and local economies healthy and current.
Currently, trends show that U.S. students have made great gains in math and science, while their counterparts in international countries around the world have made even more gains.
I think the research is telling us that we're not where we need to be internationally with respect to science, technology, engineering, mathematics. We need to beef that up.
It's a challenge area educators take seriously.
A majority of the fastest growing companies in Pennsylvania will require the skill sets from workers that are achieved through science, technology, and engineering and math skills. In order to meet those needs, we'll need to equip those students so that they can compete in the world marketplace.
At the Bethlehem Area Vocational Technical School, students get hands-on and up close to the STEM field they choose to study.
You can put a socket in if you want.
We're trying to get the kids in here, and we're trying to get them the opportunity of seeing what's available for the future.
In this pre-engineering course, high school students like 17-year-old Serena Bowen explore electrical engineering by building circuit boards that will power a robot like this one.
They like the fact that they don't just learn the theory of it. They get to try everything out. No matter what area of engineering we do, if it's civil engineering, they learn about how to survey, and we go out and we actually survey a lot. But when we're doing electronics, they learn the theory of the circuits, and then they actually get to build the circuits. So they spend a lot of time using what they learn. They don't just learn it in a book. They always get to try it out.
Math's always come quickly to this Nazareth area high school senior, so engineering seems a natural fit. This class helps Serena choose which field she likes the best.
This really gives you like a experience in everything, so it really helped me narrow down a lot. I definitely don't like civil, but I love hydraulics and electrical so far.
Serena's leaning towards studying mechanical engineering when she starts college, but having studied the different fields isn't the only leg up she'll have on fellow freshmen. Due to a partnership with Lafayette College, students get 3 credits for completing this course.
I think it's just an amazing experience to be able to actually go into the different fields and see what you like and be able to narrow it down without actually having to do it in college first.
Administrators believe students need these kinds of experiences even before they start high school.
I think it's very important that the middle school starts to understand the needs of the society and begins to see that talent develop as early as that age.
From his office back on the Lehigh campus, Dr. Henry Odey coordinates programs to reach those younger students. In many cases, his outreach begins by dispelling some of the stigmas surrounding the STEM fields.
When you talk to students, when they think about the STEM field, they think, oh, that's the field for nerds. that's the stereotype. It's really the key is exposing these young people much early on, as early as elementary school.
He says students also need the chance to feel out the field for themselves.
It has to be interactive. It's not, the excitement, it will not come from just lectures.
Dr. Odey believes promoting these fields when students still have that enthusiasm for learning is the best way to get them interested. And who knows, it may be the best way for U.S. students to smoke the competition. For Tempo, I'm Laura McHugh reporting.